Dear students, welcome to NRS YouTube channel. So in the last class we discussed self-management skills 1. So we started that this unit and we already discussed what is self-management and why need to we manage ourselves in our professional career. And it is very important to manage ourselves to build a good life and a good it involves all the behavior of ours, our character. So it depends upon everything. So in that we discussed the meaning of self-management and we discussed what is self-management it involves. Okay, starting from the emotions to up to how we'll behave with the person. Okay, whether it is in a pleasant or unpleasant, not unpleasant situations. So that everything we discussed and we'll move on to the next one. So next we have the session 2, that is self-management skills. Okay, so what exactly it is, right? So in short, these skills have bearing on our intellectual, that nothing but cognitive skills, determined our IQ as well as and our interpersonal skills reflected by our EQ, right? And to cut the long story short, the three broad area of the skills of influences. So what he has given in the point of self-management skill, it has an intellectual skills, the some skills we have. So we get those skills from the our heredity, right? Starts from our father or forefathers, right? Okay, so that we will get that heredity in some people being a self-management, right? So it will be depend upon that your interpersonal skills and some active interpersonal activity as well as self-management skills will get from the others. So based on their experience and all, so that we have three categories of self-management skills. One is rational abilities and personal qualities. Another one we have, that is interpersonal skills, right? So we'll move on to the first one, that is rational abilities. So rational ability, these simply mean the ability to understand problem and then to find a way to effectively solve it. So this ability can be improved by diving deep into your specific area of work for its further expansion and growth. So rational ability in the sense, so to understand the problem and to get a proper solution for the problem will get only those people who has a good experience in that particular work. So they knew that what will be the problem and what is the solution for that, so they can rationally they can solve the problem, so without a delay anything. So that he has given, this ability can be improved by diving in deep into your specific area of work. So if you are a fresher, then it takes more time to get the idea about that particular work, and as well as when you get a problem, so it takes time to get a solution for that particular work. And when days has gone and when you get a when you become a well experienced in that particular specific work area of work, then definitely we'll get know that how to get the problem, how we'll get the problem and what will be the solution for that, and so that everything will be able to thought about that one particular thing. So that we call the rational abilities. Okay, so these type of skills you will get mainly when you are working into that specific work, when you are have a good experience in that particular work. Okay, so next we have personal qualities. So do you take personal initiative? Are you considered responsible? So do you take accountability seriously? What about your self-esteem? Are you social and socially sensitive? Do you adapt well? How about self-management with integrity and honesty in personal professional setups? The answers to these questions determine the presence or absence of a number of personal qualities, right? So personal qualities, we have each and every person has a different personal qualities we have. Okay, and to manage yourself you need to study about that, what are the personal initiative you have taken, and what are the responsibility you have taken in your career, and what about your self-esteem, okay, and what will be the relationship with the social sensitive you have or not, and that everything you have to study about that. So then only we'll get a proper meaning of about the personal qualities. Okay. So next we have interpersonal skill. Interpersonal skills, in the sense, these include the ability to participate as a member of a team, serve clients, customers, act like a leader when the situation demands, negotiate and work with the ease even with the people who came from different cultural backgrounds. So interpersonal skills means it depends upon that along with the work, along with your professional career work, so how you have built a relationship with the employees and how you have carried out your personal work, your professional work, how you have balanced, so that everything will be come up with the interpersonal skills, right? And how you behave with the customers, right? How you have maintained the situations, so that everything will be comes under interpersonal skills, right? So these are the three main categories we have in self-management skills. And next we have factors building self-confidence and help in honing self-management skills. So what are the factors will be come up in the building of self-confidence and how they will be helpful for us? And here is when there are enough reason for you to start honing your self-management skills. Below given are some area that you can start working on. So in order to build self-confidence, what were the some main reasons we have to the points we need to implement in our career? So that the first one is locus of control. So locus of control is the degree to which you perceive control over a situation, being internal or external. It refers to the range of belief that you hold in terms of being controlled by self or controlled by others or the situation. So locus of control, in the sense, when you are in a working in a company or when you are in a professional life, so you need to control yourself that sometimes you may get a more work and you may tired with the work, and that should not be affect to the employees, or it should not be affect to your colleague, right? Or it should not be affect to your higher authority or the company, right? So it should be in a control, that it depends upon the self-confidence, that we call it as locus of control, right? So it refers to the range of beliefs that you hold in terms of being controlled by self, right? So you have some complexity of that risk of, that is, whether it is internal or external, right? So in the both situation you need to control yourself, right? So that is comes under locus of control. Next we have self efficiency. It refers to belief about your own ability to deal with events and challenges. High self-efficacy result in ability of staying happy even with a little, and having greater confidence in dealing with a variety of situations of varying degree of difficulties. So self-efficacy, so you need to implement yourself in your professional life to take care about your professional career, and it should take you to the in a smooth manner, right? So that even in the future also, that it will help you to make you stay happy with your working condition, right? So next we have self-esteem. It is your general feeling of self-worth. Individuals with high self-esteem have positive feelings about themselves, while those who with a low self-esteem are strongly affected by what others think of them and may view themselves negatively with the criticized by others. So self-esteem, in the sense, so whatever your position is, whether you are in a higher position or lower position, it is a secondary thing, right? So you can love your work, you can just concentrate on your work, so then definitely you will get a success in your professional career. So some people, they will think they are working in a small position, and what the people they think about that position and what they give respect or not, so just they will just go on to thinking of such things, negativity. So being a self confidence, if you want to build, so you need to overcome, and you have to come out of these mentality, negative mentality, right? So next we have self monitoring and positive thinking. Self monitoring and positive thinking. So these two we'll see in the next class. Thank you.